incredibly delayed announcement of who our next president would be. And, you know, Webby and I would sat there and laid there and, you know, tried to fight the sleep sometimes because it, you know, the moderators were just trying to keep the chatter going because obviously, you know, they were running out of things to say because they thought that it would just be pretty quickly that, you know, of course, states like Pennsylvania, North Carolina would be forthcoming, New Hampshire would be forthcoming because, of course, you know, we were on the eastern coastline and we closed the polls first on this side of the world, but or the United States. But they were some of the last ones to, you know, hang in there and say that Donald Trump was the victor in those states. And it was really grueling. I mean, you know, we watched as the Electoral College votes were counted and, you know, Hillary really never got to the point. She never caught Trump with the as the votes were being posted. But, you know, it was close. And there for a while, it was just up for grabs. It was anybody's ball game. And it was an exhausting ball game. But hasn't that been true for this whole election process? It was anybody's ball game. Now, I had made a prediction, and I'm going to open the envelope today on Just Ask Joyce. And Garrett was the keeper of the envelope, and he is not here yet. He is battling traffic. Bless his heart. Let me tell you, I have battled traffic until I am just exhausted with it myself. But, you know, I'm going to open the envelope and reveal to you, because I made a prediction in March, and Gary can't wait till I open this envelope. You've really been waiting for this, haven't you?
Oh, I have, yeah.
I know, you want to...
You've had it stored in a bank vault, right?
Well, until I gave it to Garrett.
Yeah.
And then Garrett has been the keeper of the envelope because I didn't want to, you know, say, hey, I had opened it and changed my prediction or whatever. And so we're going to see what JAJ predicted today on after all these many months. But it's, you know, when you think about it, I mean, from January until, you know, yesterday, we've covered this political campaign. And it has been one, Gary, like none other, has it not?
Exactly.
Everyone, and there were some, you know, some pundits on there that were saying, you know, I've been through a lot. I've been through a lot with a lot of presidents, and I've never seen anything like this.
And I was going between different channels and watching, and
as was I, yeah.
There was one channel that predicted that it could mathematically end in a tie.
Yeah.
Both of them getting 269.
Right.
Well, that didn't happen.
That didn't happen, no.
And, I went to bed. I'm trying to think.
Did you hang on till the end?
Well, I went to bed at about 2 o'clock, and my phone kept going off. So I've got an app on my phone where, you know, I'm a cable TV subscriber, and I can watch the channels on my phone. And I had to stay with it.
It's something that I could not, and bless Webby's heart.
I'm glad I did, but I'm tired today.
I am so tired. But, you know, I think I'm emotionally drained because it was something that really kept your attention. It's like one of those, you know, sci-fi movies, you know, like one of those really, those thrillers, like, Star Wars or something. It just keeps you on the edge of your seats and... that was how it was, but there was just this gut-wrenching agony as I was going through it because, you know, and I knew it was anybody's ballgame, but Hillary actually, I believe, pulled it out in the popular vote.
Yes, she did.
And, you know, the Electoral College, and I will back up and say, I'm no longer disgruntled with that this morning, you know, but because I have had a problem with the Electoral College vote in the past. And Chris Garrett was he was wonderful. And again, guys, before he gets here, remember today we're going to call and we're going to just thank Garrett for informing, educating, preparing us for this election. But Garrett, you know, tried to straighten us out on this Electoral College thing and why it was so necessary.
And it really is when you think about it.
When you think about it, and, you know, I know when it doesn't go for my favor, I'm not so happy with it.
You don't like it so much.
I don't like it so much, but then when it goes, to my favor, I was kind of like, okay, well, that made sense. But, you know, I was a little surprised, quite frankly, that she even got the popular vote. And I guess only because California has, you know, so many people, and I guess everybody wants to live in California.
Well, and a lot of people are saying, too, about Johnson, that, you know, the people who basically, you know, everybody said, if you don't vote for Clinton or you don't vote for Trump, you're throwing your vote away.
How many Johnson get?
I got quite a, he got enough to it's kind of like when Ross Perot ran.
Right.
He changed the outcome of it, I really do think.
And, you know, that did make a difference. And, of course, McMullen got, you know, some votes in Utah?
Yeah.
But anyway, so, but it was like, you know, a masterpiece unfolding last night. But you have to, I don't care what side of the fence that you were on, you have to agree that Donald Trump beat every odd known to a political campaign. He beat all odds.
And he beat the polls, too.
He beat the polls.
Yeah.
He beat the media. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I think that when I'm looking at this, and we'll hear more from Garrett when he gets here. We can't wait to hear from Garrett today.
Lots of audio here today, too.
Oh, you got lots of audio, yeah. You're going to be hearing from, you know, some of the people that, the victory speech, and the introduction to that from Pence and Paul Ryan.
And the concession part.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you just heard some from our president, but you know, it was amazing to me. The message that came out last night was, you know what? This is our voice. No longer is America going to sit on her voice. And it told the media something for me, and I was really happy about that message to the media, because it let them know, you don't control us. You don't control us. We can think for ourselves. We can do our own digging. We can look. We can analyze. We can figure it out. We're not stupid, media. A lot of them think that, you know, we're just little puppets, and we'll just go along with whatever they tried to shove down our throats. And I believe that it was a loud and clear message to the media that you don't control us. You don't. And so I was grateful for that message, loud and clear to them. And even, you know, the social media, because social media played a huge part in this election this time. You know, never before have we seen social media, you know.
And a lot of people have lost some friends because of social media, too.
Unfortunately. And, you know, I heard from both sides last night and this morning, because Hillary, of course, didn't do her concession last night. But I heard from both sides that, you know, we need to unify. You know, we need to come together as a nation. And I pray that that is going to be where we are. Now, I'm kind of with Rush Limbaugh on this, where I feel like for a couple of weeks, maybe even a month, it might go along where the unification is going to be what we hear. But then eventually, you know, we'll see some, you know, radical division. But I will share with you something that I feel like we need to be aware of. It will not be popular to some of you, I understand. But I believe that we need to know what is down for us for the next 71 days that Obama is in office. We'll be back. Don't go away.
WFIA, The Spirit.
Hey, this is Chris Brown with Chris Brown's True Stewardship. This Christmas, we're giving away $100,000 worth of cash and prizes until December 21st as part of our Making Futures Bright $100,000 giveaway. There's no purchase necessary, and you can enter to win at stewardship.com. And while you're there, be sure to pick up one of our incredible $10 gifts for someone that you care about. Again, you can find great gifts and the $100,000 giveaway at stewardship.com.
I'm always listening to music on my phone, but I don't always have Wi-Fi.
Honey, wait for the next one.
And I don't always have data to spare.
Oh, cheese, mustard, ketchup, relish. Nuts.
With Next Radio, you have radio on your smartphone. There's no subscription, and it uses 3 times less battery and 10 times less data than streaming. With Next Radio, I can keep going and keep my music going.
With the Next Radio app, you can interact with radio and get your music on the go, all while using 3 times less battery and 10 times less data than streaming.
Next Radio.
Do you have thoughts about changing your life to become healthier, live life more fully, and be happier? Well, all of these things can happen when you have a plan, an ally, and put a support system into place. Introducing health and wellness coach Julia Campbell of The Healthiest You. What would you like to change? Lose weight and become more active? Stop smoking? Maybe manage stress and improve your diet? All of these lifestyle changes have a better chance of success with health and wellness coach Julia Campbell. She can help you ensure success through support and accountability, and she'll help you track your progress and maintain motivation from within. The Healthiest You with health and wellness coach Julia Campbell, your ally for making educated choices and then making change happen. Adopting new ways and attitudes, doubling, even tripling your chances of staying on course over trying it alone. Try a 12-week program and see that making the right choices with proper motivation can increase your chances of success. Call Julia Campbell today at 502-384-5143 or online at thehealthiestyou.org.
Welcome to Staples.
Staples guy, I have to move fast in business. Gotta go, go, go.
Well, then you need to see the all-new redesigned HP OfficeJet Pro printers.
Are they fast?
They're lightning fast and deliver two-sided prints, which saves you time and money. You can even print from your smartphone.
Sounds perfect.
And now at Staples, you can save up to $100 on one.
Fast, efficient, and I save money? So I can relax.
I can see the tension melting.
Yep, gotta go.
Away. Now save up to $100 on a fast new HP OfficeJet Pro. And save every day on ink and toner. Staples. Make more happen.
For limited time, see store staples.com for details. Restrictions may apply.
There is a radio station on the air right now where you can take your family and not be embarrassed. Where you can find hope when things seem the darkest. Where you can understand life's challenges and what to do about them. This is that radio station. We are WFIA The Spirit. And now we're available live, online, and on your mobile app at christianradio.com. And the good news is we're in good company. Only stations like ours are invited in. Join us now online and on your mobile app at christianradio.com.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
It is my high honor and distinct privilege to introduce to you the President-elect of the United States of America, Donald Trump.
That was, of course, Governor Pence last night with his introduction to President-elect Trump. And, yeah, I think Pence really added a lot. He brought along quite an array of benefits for Trump. He's just so eloquent when he speaks. I think he has a very warm and approachable tenor about him. His personality is very inviting. And so, you know, I felt like that he really complimented and brought balance to Donald Trump and this campaign. But Garrett Sivaking is here with us today. We're going to open the phone lines for you. You can certainly call in and talk about last night, if you were the ones that stayed up, and you know how you're faring today, because I tell you, you know, my wagon's dragging. I don't know about you, but I have pulled a couple of long nights before last night, but I could not, it didn't matter how tired I was, I could not watch what was going on last night to the bitter end. But Garrett, welcome back, actually, to see your face front on. I mean, you know, yeah. you've been you're exhausted too. Now you've had a lot going on, haven't you?
Oh yeah. And of course I worked the election yesterday and was up for a good majority of the 24 hours. Took a little nap a little bit.
What
early
time did you have to show up at the polls?
I had to be at the voting center by 5 o'clock. So we were there at 5 and was up at 3 doing some other things and helping some clients. And then one of my clients, Kelly Ayotte, we're still trying to figure that out. It's still no winner at this point.
No winner. So. It's a mandatory recount, understand with that.
716 votes. So once again, guys, out of a little bit over a million votes in a race, 716 people could decide this election in the state of New Hampshire. So those of you who think your vote doesn't count, it really does.
It really does.
It really does.
716 is the dividing line there. Of course, New Hampshire was really slow about coming back in last night.
Well, it wasn't necessarily that it was slow. It was that the vote was so close there, too. If we go back and look at the final totals from New Hampshire, let me find it here real quick. New Hampshire was 48-47. It looks like Hillary Clinton will win the state of New Hampshire. Mm-hmm. But that's, once again, that is with a little less than 5,000 votes between the two of them there.
Not much at all.
So
she got all three delegates there. Did she?
Yeah, that one. That one is a winner take all. No, that one's a winner. Maine is the one.
Maine
that split.
Is the one that was split. And what
happened
Maine
there? Is going to Donald Trump will win the second congressional district, so he will win one, and it was close as well, 48-45 statewide.
It was all of them were really close, didn't you think? I mean,
well, I mean, with the exception of a few, you know, Wyoming was the biggest, where 70-23 for Donald Trump. West Virginia also 69-27. That wasn't a huge shock for anybody.
Those critical states were very, very close.
Were very close. Florida was 48-47. Michigan 48-47. You know, even some of the states that nobody really thought would be too close ended up being closer. The biggest shock was, of course, Ohio, the one they thought was really close. It was ended up being 52-44. Because even in the middle of the results coming in from Ohio, it was a long time that she had the lead.
Yes.
And so it was extremely disappointing for her team. And I think that's when I started to realize when Cuyahoga County, which is Cleveland, started to come in and the turnout was not high enough for her and the vote wasn't going to be high enough to hold her out for those rural counties.
It was interesting because I caught a segment of an interview about Cuyahoga County yesterday. And it was a Democrat that was talking, and he was saying that there has been a big influx of Democrats moving into that county, and they were confident that, you know, that was going to be, you know, it was going to seize Ohio for them. They were they were pretty confident about Ohio yesterday.
Yes. Well, even in Jefferson County here in Louisville, I mean, Donald Trump won handily in the Commonwealth of Kentucky and the state of Indiana, but Hillary Clinton came nowhere near the amount of support that Barack Obama got either in Louisville or in Indianapolis, for that matter. Both major cities, those urban areas, tend to go Democratic. They did go Democratic, but not to the extent that Barack Obama had. She clearly did not remake the Obama coalition, whether it was young people, minorities, or even women. That was not, she did not win the number that she did. What was shocking to most all of us was that she got 16% of evangelicals, which was something that none of us really anticipated. But also, what was shocking is that the number really didn't go down from Mitt Romney's participation. It stayed about the same. And that was something that a lot of people thought that evangelicals would not turn out in the same numbers as they had the last three election cycles. They actually did. They actually did. So that was something.
In great numbers. I mean, it was really remarkable. Yeah. But so you were surprised about the 16%?
I was, because
why so?
Well, and by the way, that 16% doesn't necessarily mean that they all went for Hillary Clinton. It was just that's what was left over. And I think part of that goes with some of the Western states, because really the big shock of the, not really shock to me, but the big third party candidate ended up being Evan McMillan getting 20-something percent in Utah in particular, but had done well in some Western states that, but didn't do enough to even overcome Donald Trump, because there for a while they thought he could overcome Donald Trump. But instead, there was in Utah in particular, he came in second.
Right. Right.
So I think that plays into the evangelical vote. But I was shocked to see that many people come out in support of Hillary Clinton.
I wasn't.
Well,
I wasn't. I mean, I just wasn't, you know. Yeah. And quite frankly, I thought there might be a little bit more. Mm-hmm. And, you know, so I was glad not, of course. But
she got greater numbers than Barack Obama did in evangelicals. And that's the one group that she outperformed him. Mm-hmm. And that's what was so shocking in that sense.
Right. So how much do you think that the Obamacare scare now that I think that people really have? I mean, you know, it's kind of swept the nation. Like, you know, we're ever increasing more aware of how that's going to hit us. Mm-hmm. How much do you think that factored into her loss?
Well, I think there were several things. That's one
of
them.
Yeah, I know, but that particular one.
Well, I don't know that it was a huge impact because I still go with my, from what I said all along. And that's how the map turned out, by the way, is the fact that I said who wins the Rust Belt wins the presidency, and that's exactly what happened. Mm-hmm. She did not have the union support that she thought she would. I think that this amount of support was there all along for Donald Trump. Wisconsin was the big shock of the night to most people.
Yeah.
But like I said, I thought if he takes Wisconsin, that shows you. I mean, and it was Iowa, Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, Ohio, West Virginia, even the eastern part of Kentucky. And now you go into where Michigan, where it's too close to call. That's a huge deal for the Republican Party and a huge deal for Donald Trump.
Were you...
I think that the Obamacare isn't as big of a deal because I don't think anybody's fears are assuaged today. That's one of the things that I hear from a lot of people. They may understand that their premiums may not go up and that the Affordable Care Act may not exist, but we really don't know what's going to exist from this point forward.
Yeah.
There's a lot of uncertainty on that front.
A whole lot.
And I think that people are going to have to wait and see how mm-hmm. it's going to play out. But at least we know now with the balance of Congress, even without Kelly Ayotte, the Republicans will gain control. It will not be decided by the vice presidency. It would just add one more vote. And that was another devastating blow because they didn't even pick up some of their sure wins. Indiana being that, Evan Bayh being beaten, especially at the margin that he was beaten at, is devastating to the Democratic Party.
Oh, I'm sure. I was concerned for that race mm-hmm. as well, but happy to see mm-hmm. the turnout for Todd Young. Mm-hmm. All right, guys, we will open the phone lines, 571-2428, 571-CHAT, if you want to call in and talk about how you feel today after the results last night. We'll be waiting for your call. Don't go away.
WFIA, The Spirit.
Call today to reserve space for your business.
In the annual 2017 Southeast Outlook Business Directory, in addition to 30,000 copies distributed through the mail in over 400 racks around Kentuckiana, you'll appear on the directory website.
Distribution starts February 23rd of 2017 and throughout the year.
Your company will benefit from the 2017 Southeast Outlook Business Directory by reaching a qualified niche market with citywide coverage. Be visible for your customers in this handy and trusted source.
Call before January 27, 2017, 253-8650.
Hi, my name is Caroline. I'm a senior at Christian Academy. I love being in show choir, in theater, and a part of the chapel team. But a school is more than just activities, and that's what makes Christian Academy such a special place to me. It's a place with amazing spirit, especially at the football games. I feel prepared for college, but I also feel prepared spiritually to defend my faith in the real world. I love how Christian Academy is a place where we can talk about the Lord freely. I am blessed my parents have given me the opportunity that they never had to attend a Christian school. If you want your child to grow academically while growing spiritually, Christian Academy is the place. We have 4 campuses in Louisville, in Southern Indiana, and special Welcome Wednesday tours. I love Christian Academy, and I am thankful for the many memories it has brought me. Christian Academy will always hold a special place in my heart.
Our 4 locations in Louisville and Southern Indiana are now holding open houses. Check out Christian Academy on the web for dates and times.
This is Michael Medved for townhall.com. A new report from the American Cancer Society highlights the tragic toll of smoking-related cancers. 167,000 deaths in the most recent yearly statistics from tobacco-caused cancer alone, not even including additional smoking-based deaths caused by other lung and circulatory problems. Now, this means the number of cancer victims who perish due to cigarettes exceeds the number of American murders, suicides, terrorist victims, and traffic fatalities combined. Interestingly, the rate of smoking-based cancers varies widely from state to state. In Kentucky, more than a third of all cancer deaths are derived from cigarettes, but in Utah, the rate was only 16%. That encouraging number reflected the ban on tobacco products by the Mormon Church, but even without religious strictures, every American family can choose to do more, to quit smoking, while discouraging the habit in the younger generation. I'm Michael Medved.
Shakes and Scallops, roofing, shutters and gutters, soffit and fascia, vinyl sidings, doors, and, yes, windows. Along with their attractive merchandise and professional installation, they also have an incredible peace of mind lifetime warranty. Yep, from the date of installation, Window World will be there to service any defects in material or workmanship. Now that's the kind of people I love to deal with. Call Window World today at 502-671-7777, 671-7777, and visit their website at windowworldlouisville.com.
Once I was 7 years old.
Don't miss your chance to join WFIA and special guest Louisville's own Lincoln Bridge, one of the top finalists from this year's America's Got Talent show. As we join Focus on the Family and Orphan Care Alliance for Wait No More 2016, Saturday, November 12th from 10 to 2. It's a free event at Little Flock Baptist in Shepherdsville, finding families for Kentucky's waiting kids. We want to find homes for 350 children on that day. You know somebody wanting to adopt? We'll have agency and county reps right there on site to help you get started. We're going to have a great time, and it's free. In fact, with your free registration, we're going to give you a free bag of goodies and resources, plus a free lunch. And, of course, your chance to see Lincoln Bridge live and up close, absolutely free. To get registered, go to iCareAboutOrphans.org and sign up now. Wait no more, Kentuckiana. Go to iCareAboutOrphans.org right now and get registered from Focus on the Family, Orphan Care Alliance, and your friends at WFIA.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
I've just received a call from Secretary Clinton. She congratulated us, it's about us, on our victory. And I congratulated her and her family on a very, very hard-fought campaign. I mean, she fought very hard. Hillary has worked very long and very hard over a long period of time, and we owe her a major debt of gratitude for her service to our country. I mean that very sincerely.
All right, you hear Donald Trump, and that was at his victory speech last night, or very early this morning. Many of you might have stayed up to watch it all as it all unfolded. We know that Garrett Sivaking did, and he is here today with us. And, you know, as I think he probably is in my camp where his wagon's dragging just because we're spent. But let me tell you, I've been up for other reasons. Gary's been up because of this election for some elongated hours and nights, and at the polls a lot. Gary, people really turned out in record numbers this year. Early voting was much more tremendous than ever before, don't you think?
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, especially in Floyd County, right across the river there in New Albany, 20,000 plus people came out to cast their ballot before Election Day. And I think that early voting should be expanded. I think it's extremely important that we do that. It did relieve a lot of the pressure on us compared to other counties from people that I spoke to on Election Day. It was much smoother. The people did not have to wait as long. They were able to not have to, you know, rush home from work or rush home from dropping the kids or take the kids with them and things of that nature that puts a burden on them. They can come in. And it especially helps elderly people who cannot stand mm-hmm. for that period of time mm-hmm. Because not every place is going to be accommodating to that. Right. And it really does assist them in being able to cast their ballot in person early.
I got my thought process about that, you know, somewhat changed because mm-hmm. I've always felt like, you know, Election Day was just so sacred and it should just be set aside for that. And I wasn't sure about all the early voting. But, you know, so many people travel mm-hmm. these days. And so a lot of those votes would not have been counted. Right. Because, you know, maybe, you know, they're out of town or mm-hmm. they would have to leave before and not get back before the polls close. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, I can see where that might have been a benefit more so than what, you know, I was thinking. But, you know, you get in this thought pattern of, mm-hmm. oh, well, it's always been this way and why are we changing?
Right.
But we have Debbie on the line. Hi, Debbie. How are you?
Hi, Joyce and Garrett.
Hi.
This is Debbie, and I just am so thrilled with the outcome. Did the American people pulled off. And I know that some of that was due to the dedication and work of Joyce Oglesby and Garrett.
Thank you.
Because you kept us educated, you kept us, you know, you kept giving us hope, and of course, giving us a good butt whooping when we needed it, because so many people needed to get out and vote. Now, I've voted every year that I've been able to vote since I was 18, but I finally got my son-in-law to vote, you know, which was just amazing because he just said it never changed anything. But, you know, we had many talks about that, about it's such a waste to throw that away. But I really wanted to thank you all for just beating the horse until we got to the actual polls and got in there and did something. And it's not so much for me a thrill that Trump won. It's a thrill that, yes, the people of the United States, and when they stand up with a mighty roar, nothing can take that away from us if we will do it. And we did this without the blessing of the Republican Party, as well as fighting the enemy on the other side.
We, you know, Trump certainly had a lot of obstacles to fight, for sure. But, yes, you know, it was in the end, I still believe that he really did have the pulse on what the people were feeling. And I feel like that was a huge impetus to his campaign. But I will ditto you with saying, you know, not so much me as making, you know, informing and educating, but Garrett has just done an amazing job.
Yes.
And, you know, I'll, the only thing I give myself credit for is that it was a stroke of wisdom from God that I choose Garrett and ask him to come along beside us with this campaign this year. And so thank you, Debbie, for that. And we've
it's
got
been
Bink
my pleasure too.
On hold. And Bink, we got to run to a break, but I can't wait to hear from you because you had a theory yesterday. And
I did.
Well, we got to go to a break.
At least to tell true for Indiana and Kentucky about a complete sweep.
All right. Well, we got to go. Hey, Bink, we got to go to a break. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
WFIA, The Spirit.
8 years of earning the Good Housekeeping Seal? 8 years. That's nothing to sneeze at. 0% financing is something to take special note of as well. Superior Products, low pricing gives you an advantage of renovating and or building your dream home. With windows, doors, vinyl siding, and roofing, Window World's online design showcase is easy to navigate, and in the comfort of your own home, you can choose style and color options, grid and cut glass styles. Call Window World today at 502-671-7777, 671-7777.
Hi, I'm Roger Berkman of U of L's 1980 National Championship team. Shortly after I graduated, a group of U of L students and alumni created their very own credit union, the University of Louisville Student and Alumni Credit Union. Today, that credit union is Class Act. Not just anybody can become a member, but you can if you or a family member has ever attended U of L. You see, I'm not only a member of U of L's first national championship team, I'm also a member of Class Act. Class Act, it's like straight A's for your money. Member NCUA.
Hi, this is Steve Arterman. Join us for New Life Live each weekday. Real people, real issues, and real answers.
My husband and I have been married for a year.
My question was, what does integrity look like in a man?
She's doing the laundry.
Yeah, she's down in the coal mine.
Okay, she's down in the coal mine doing her thing.
Doing your laundry.
Doing her thing.
Here's the biblical principle.
It seems like there's a real disconnect between how she sees things and how you see things.
New Life Live, weekday afternoons at 1 on WFIA, The Spirit.
The real estate market is hot right now. Are you thinking of buying or selling your home in this market? Do you have any questions about preparing your home to sell? Are you even thinking about real estate investing? Do you have questions about financing a piece of property, or should you refinance your current home? Let me assist you in all of your real estate needs. Hire the hardest working real estate agent you'll ever meet, Elizabeth Monarch with Keller Williams Louisville. When the time comes to making that important decision of buying or selling your home, call me. I want to be your realtor. Search for All Homes at ElizabethMonarchGroup.com. Like me on Facebook. That's Elizabeth Monarch with Keller Williams Louisville at 502-551-1286. ElizabethMonarchGroup.com, the hardest working real estate agent you'll ever meet.
show, we've been saddled with the impossible task of telling you all the things your new WFIA app can do. Ready? Stream with the touch of a button. Go to our webpage, our Facebook, our Twitter. Shop Owlery.club with the touch of a button. Send us emails instantly. Send us voice messages instantly. Call us with one touch. Take an instant poll with one touch. Scroll through and listen to one of our podcasts. Get live feeds from Christian headlines, from daily devotionals, national ministries, and more. But we're out of time. You know, you can get it all free right now from WFIAFM.com.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
All right, we are wrapping up election selection 2016 for good because, okay, it's over. It's over, and so we're just kind of, you know, putting a bow on the package.
Not for good. We'll have other
we'll
elections.
Not 16.
Yeah.
Not 2016. Yeah. We'll have election selection again, but not 2016. We'll have to call it 2020.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have a lot. Well, you may have to
Maybe the
2018. Here's the surprising one, though. You may have to have an election selection coming up with this because of what happened last night here in Kentucky.
Mm.
95 years of Democratic control of the House of Representatives. And not only did the Republicans take the House of Representatives to give the backup for Matt Bevin, but Mr. Stumbo had a rebuke and lost his seat last night.
Wow. I know. That was cool.
That was that tells you how much support Matt Bevin really has in this Congress.
He's doing a great job. And Bink, thank you so much for being patient. And I'm so glad you called back.
Well, I promised you I would.
Yes, you did.
And I think my prediction held out for Indiana and Kentucky. The result, I guess, nationwide is still the same. I have contacted a few of those friends, and where they're standing right now is they're just kind of standing, you know, sitting back and saying, okay, the ball is in his court. We gave it to him, and I don't think the Republicans ought to get on their, and even though I am a registered Republican, I don't think that it's time for us to get on our soapbox yet, because I think it was given to us to finally say, you better do something.
Right.
You better do something. And I think that's actually what happened with that 95 years in Kentucky is, they've just been going on and on and on. And I think it just turned because now it's like, you better do something or it's going to be over quick.
And you're right, Bink. We've given it to him, and now he's got to perform. And if he doesn't, you know, the Americans will speak again in another way coming up. So
that's absolutely true. Mm-hmm. And like I told you yesterday, I listened to a lot of talk radio. And during election time, a lot of the other side of the board National Public Radio and all of those, and all of their talk shows were off this morning, pretty much all day long. I don't know if you listen to them or not, but they canceled all of their shows, which I thought was just hilarious. But, the ones that were, that had done interviews, I mean, there was people, it literally sounded like crying in the streets over this. So, I mean, it's definitely interesting. It's something I'm glad I was a part of, being here to remember back. But it was a
history-making night for sure.
I think that first 100 days between, the January 21st and May 1st, I think that's where he's going to have to
be telling. Yeah. Well, we all need to be praying for him. If Hillary had gotten in office, I'd be saying the same thing. We all need to pray. Garrett, if he's done anything, he's taught us that we need to be praying for our leaders daily.
We need to be praying for Hillary Clinton this morning.
Yes, we do. And I already have. Mm-hmm. And but thank you, Bink, so much. We got another call, but God bless you. All right. You keep it up. Keep listening. And we have Kathleen Saucier on the line. And Kathleen, thank you so much for calling back. And, you and I exchanged some texts this morning, and I just said, why don't you call back and just let us hear from you this morning? Thank you for taking the time the other day to call in about your son, and we have Chris in our prayers. But how are you feeling today?
So, Joyce, I've been watching the TV all morning. How I feel today is hopeful. I feel hopeful that we have an opportunity to go forward and focus on, identifying the double standards. You know, that's going to be continuing to be my mission and my purpose, I believe, in my life now, is to focus on double standards and raising awareness. You know, you mentioned before I came on, and I've been saying this all along to people to pray for Hillary Clinton. I feel the same way. I've been really clear with the editors on my page, and we've all talked about the importance of our mission. We've focused hard on acknowledging the fact that we believe there was corruption and criminal activity on her part and her staff, but we also need to focus on how can we make America great again? How can we come together in a purpose and a mission, unite United States of America? Because they are hurting. The people that stood by Hillary Clinton have supported her. They are hurting right now, and it's not our goal. And one of the things I said yesterday was before the election happened was that no matter what the outcome is, that we are going to continue to raise awareness about double standards, and we will stand behind our leader, our President of the United States, and go forward, and whoever that might be. And it is Donald Trump, and we will stand behind him, but we will hold him accountable as well, just as we will anyone else.
Amen. Well, God bless you, and I know that you've really been out, pushing your message, and it wasn't a message for as much for Donald Trump as it was for the right, just do the right thing by everyone concerned. It doesn't matter whether it was your son or whether it's Hillary Clinton or whomever. We just want justice to prevail and it to be equal across the board. But your double standard message is strong, and I would encourage you to carry it on. But God bless you for that. Thank you so much for calling.
Amen. And remember our Facebook page, American Patriots Against Double Standards, and we look forward to going forward this year. As someone mentioned just in your previous caller about those first 100 days, they're so important. And, Donald Trump has a lot of work to do. But one thing I keep saying, everyone's like, Donald Trump's in. Yes, Donald Trump's in, but we, the United States of America, need to support Donald Trump and the people that are there to make a difference and to make some changes. America can't be great again by one man.
Right.
It needs to be all of us together.
All of us working together for the common cause. Mm-hmm. God bless you. Thank you so much.
Amen.
We'll be praying for you and your son, Chris. God bless.
Thank you. Take care.
All right. Take care. All right. And we have Dave and Pam. You just sit tight. I think Dave was the first caller. So, Dave, thank you for calling in.
Hi, Joyce. Dave again.
Yeah.
Once again, I'd like to say thank you for voting for all that did. Second thing, I do have a question for you. I'll go get off and you can answer it. I'll be listening.
Okay.
How come the vote was so close? I know that America was set there and just had their differences, but I didn't think it'd be as close as it was. I mean, it was a thin margin.
Mm-hmm. It was a thin margin. All right. Well, that's a good question. And we were kind of going through some of that. Today, we were talking about whether it was Obamacare. You said there were several things, Garrett, that you felt like contributed to not only the big turnout, but we were a divided nation.
Well, the turnout overall was down. The mm-hmm. turnout, there was a big turnout in certain states.
Right.
And that kind of plays a big difference. Of course, like we said earlier, or I think like you and Gary said when I was walking in, Hillary Clinton got more votes. That's going to be the truth of the story. It's going to be tight. Once again, your vote counting, literally less than 100,000 we're talking about
right.
here on this. Our nation really is divided. It kind of goes with what I said about the LA Times poll. The LA Times poll all along said 44-44. It ended up coming together where it was like 49-49, but there's very close. American people are divided on this issue. I don't think we had two of the most disliked presidential candidates in our history. I think that while some are very joyful today, the majority of Americans are just in shock and in worry of what will happen. And I think it's Donald Trump's going to have to assuage those fears.
Yes. And Pam, can you hold on, darling, till we get back?
Sure.
All right. We'll come back after this short message because our sponsors are necessary to keep these kinds of shows going for you. So you listen to that. But we'll be back with the wrap up of Election Selection 2016 after this short break.
WFIA, The Spirit.
Hey, this is Chris Brown with Chris Brown's True Stewardship. This Christmas, we're giving away $100,000 worth of cash and prizes until December 21st as part of our Making Futures Bright $100,000 giveaway. There's no purchase necessary, and you can enter to win at stewardship.com. And while you're there, be sure to pick up one of our incredible $10 gifts for someone that you care about. Again, you can find great gifts and the $100,000 giveaway at stewardship.com.
Do you have a family member who's getting older and can no longer be safely left alone? With Visiting Angels America's Choice in Senior Home Care, your parents and older family members can continue living at home and not have to move into a nursing home. Experienced, compassionate caregivers provide assistance in hygiene, meal preparation, and light housework up to 24 hours per day at affordable rates. To restore your family's peace of mind, call Visiting Angels toll-free today at 877-374-LIVE or at visitingangels.com.
Just as God is using WFIA in your life, God is using TWR through Bonaire. This is a good ministry that WFIA is 100% behind, a ministry you can trust. We encourage you to get behind this incredible project, this opportunity to reach Cuba with the gospel of Jesus. Imagine Christian radio coming to Havana. You can make that happen. Call now, 888-256-1600, or go online to WFIAFM.com and give generously. We are excited to partner with TWR in this effort. By joining hands with an international radio organization like TWR, WFIA is helping bring great Christian radio to Havana and the rest of Cuba. You're a big part of that. Your gift will make it possible. Will you call right now? You can reach TWR operators at 888-256-1600 or at the WFIA website at WFIAFM.com.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
Every single American will have the opportunity to realize his or her fullest potential. The forgotten men and women of our country will be forgotten no longer.
You know, and I think that right there was kind of epitomized Donald Trump's campaign that, you know, a lot of people did feel like they were the forgotten citizen, that they were the forgotten ones. They were out just working and making America churn, but we were forgotten. And Pam, thank you so much for calling in, sweetheart.
I just wanted to tell Garrett, thank you very much. I have certainly enjoyed his humble spirit. And I can hear it in his voice today that he's not boasting over who won the election. I mean, I kind of stumbled up on this radio station, just turning the channels, and I've been watching. I've been listening to it for a long time. And I just really enjoyed his wisdom and just his humble spirit. And I can recall, I don't know all the station, I'm sure you get many calls, but I can recall, Joyce, you were kind of in limbo with who you were going to be in the beginning, and I recall you were pulling for Ben Carson in the beginning, and you were a little uneasy for voting for Trump, and I think that's kind of what happened with a lot of people when they make their final decision. Again, I think...
Hey, Pam.
I would just like to say for all of those people that, you know, that were for Hillary, including myself, is that, you know, continue to have hope and to realize that, you know, somebody has to win and someone has to lose. And the victory is, you know, it's all in God's hands. And hopefully and personally, we can put this country back together. There's so much hatred and there's so much animosity going on. And my last comment is I can recall telling Joyce that my first call in said, you know what, Trump is going to win this election, and I have a feeling in my spirit that God is going to allow Trump to win because he's going to bring the Christians to their knees and on their faces, because Christians, as Christians, we have settled. We're compromising, and I believe this is all going to be for the grace of God and the outcome for all Christians. We're going to grow and mature. And again, Garrett, I really appreciate everything that you've done, and you be blessed.
All right, Pam, thank you so much. We were really struggling to hear her because there was interference. But, John, thank you for calling in.
Oh, my pleasure. I called Monday morning.
Yes, you did.
And my wife just pulled in, which is cool. But boy, how the world has changed! I told her Tuesday morning that Trump won, and that was before the election.
All right. And so now you know.
My comment today, Joyce, is people realize, you know, the people in Michigan, which was a very surprise, because, you know, you've got a lot of people there that have been out of work. And if Trump can bring manufacturing back and people get a job, they will be so much more proud of themselves.
Well,
they're accomplishing something.
That's right. I hope he does bring some pride back into the Americans. And
can I ask you a question?
Sure.
You know, they say the government's looking for a 1% or 1.7% inflation rate. Have you seen your insurance bill yet that's coming up next year?
No.
Oh, well, if that's 1%,
it's coming,
I'm surprised.
Some of them are a lot more than that.
Yeah, and I've got good insurance, but...
But that's, you know...
300-400%. Yeah,
we know that that's a reflection of Obamacare, so... But anyway, and I think that that's part of why America, you know, rose up, and we said something else yesterday at the poll. So, but anyway, God bless you, John. We appreciate
that.
Oh,
you have a nice day.
All right, you too, darling.
Enjoy it.
All right, guys, I promised you. Now, I'm doing this. I would tease you more, but, I know that some of you cannot listen to in the 4 o'clock hour. So I made a prediction in March about who would win this election. And Garrett has just opened the envelope. This is the first time that he has seen it. He's been the keeper of the envelope. And so he has just opened the envelope. And Garrett, you get to read my prediction.
Well, it says on March the 9th, 2016, that your prediction was Hillary wins at all costs.
That was my prediction.
And so your prediction was off, but not by much.
Not
by much. It was a shock.
Not by much. And, I knew it was going to be a battle, but I did not know that the American people would come to the conclusion that they did. Not that I didn't have faith in America. I knew that we needed to wake up, but I wasn't sure they'd wake up in time. We'll be back at 4 o'clock, and in the meantime, I'm in battle for his cause.
The Spirit, 94.7 WFIA FM, New Albany, Louisville, is a service of Salem Media Group, online at WFIAFM.com.
News this hour from townhall.com. I'm Val Dior.
It is my high honor and distinct privilege to introduce to you the president-elect of the United States of America, Donald Trump.
Vice President-elect Mike Pence announcing our new president last night after Trump's victory and so many decisions that have to be made between now and January. Republican National Committee Chairman Reince Priebus tells NBC's Today Show that's no problem. President-elect Trump is ready to get to work.
He gets it. He understands where we're at, and I think he wants to really deliver, and he wants to be a great president.
Meanwhile, Hillary Clinton finally speaking late this morning to her supporters to tell them they should not be discouraged.
This is painful. And it will be for a long time. But I want you to remember this. Our campaign was never about one person or even one election.
Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu says he's already spoken to President-elect Trump and has already received an invitation to meet at the first opportunity. The Israeli leader congratulated Trump on his win and said that the U.S. has no better ally than Israel. Relations often tense between Netanyahu and President Obama, mainly over Israel's policies toward the Palestinians and concerns over the U.S.-led nuclear deal with Iran. China's president says he looks forward to working with Trump on promoting ties in a constructive way that avoids conflict and confrontation. Russia's Vladimir Putin reaching out with the same sentiment. California, Massachusetts, and Nevada have voted to legalize the recreational use of marijuana, giving a huge boost to the campaign to allow pot nationwide. 6 more states voted on marijuana measures. And Nebraska voters reinstated the death penalty, reversing legislature's decision last year to repeal capital punishment. Nebraska has not executed an inmate since 1997. This is Town Hall News.
WFIA, The Spirit.
It is a 4 o'clock edition of Just Ask Joyce. We have just finished 1 hour of election selection 2016. It is finally over. I don't know about you, but I am worn slap dog out over this election. But finally, we have a president of the United States. Some of us are happy, some of us aren't. But you know what? We are stuck with this president for the next 4 years at least. So we need to make the best of it. And Garrett is going to be here. We're going to talk about the results from the different states and how it all panned out. And we'll open the phone lines for you if you would like to call in and bemoan or rejoice, whichever you would like to do. This show is brought to you by Roberts CPA Group. It is going to be tax time because, you know, Thanksgiving is here, then Christmas, and then, yes, the new year in taxes all over again. So you make sure when you need a CPA, you call my friend Kevin Roberts. Listen for his number. He'll be giving it next.
Celebrate the holidays with the Honky Tonk Angels Holiday Spectacular, coming November 16th to Derby Dinner Playhouse. This musical comedy follows three country gals as they reunite for a Christmas show at the Hillbilly Heaven Club and features plenty of Christmas joy, laughter, and a lineup of Christmas classics and country favorites, perfect for the holiday season. Call 288-8281 for tickets or order online at derbydinner.com.
You want to feel connected, informed, included, inspired. So when important things happen, we're here. Your local radio and TV broadcasters. America's number one source for news, weather, and information on your radio, TV, computer, tablet, and smartphone. We are broadcasters. Always here for you, wherever here may be. Tell Washington local stations matter by texting radio to 52886. Furnished by NAB and the station, message and data rates may apply.
Warning, do not drink milk while watching the hilarious clean comedy videos at GodTube.com. Extended viewing of Safe for the Family comedy at GodTube.com from Christian comedians like Tim Hawkins, Anita Renfro, Bob Smiley, and more may lead to crippling side effects such as watery eyes, runny nose, and a bright red face. At GodTube.com, non-offensive, good, clean humor leads to giggles, guffaws, and howls. Some even experience ROFL. Rolling on the floor laughing. GodTube.com may be habit-forming. That's GodTube.com. I'm not kidding. GodTube.com.
Hey, this is Kevin Roberts from Roberts CPA Group, here to talk to you about football and retirement. The draft is a lot like planning for your retirement. You do your homework, make your investments, and you hope they pay off in the end. But if you haven't created a playbook with the right strategies to play both offense and defense, then you could be losing out on time and money. Do you have a coach in your corner with the right tools and strategies to guide you to victory? In fact, that's what I wrote about in a brand new special report I created just for you. It's called Kickoff to Retirement, and it focuses on the essential draft picks you must consider before and during your retirement. What I want to do is this. I want to get this special resource into your hands for free. To claim this free resource, simply call 426-0000 or visit us online at smartmoneycpa.com. When you do, my assistant will have my calendar open, and you can claim a free one-on-one session with me to review your current strategies and create your financial game plan. Again, to put your money to work for you and gain the financial freedom you're after, call 426-0000 or visit smartmoneycpa.com.
Has God touched your heart with a passion for Messianic ministry? If so, Jim Hendricks, former president and co-founder of the Southern Baptist Messianic Fellowship, wants to meet you. Whether you're a Jewish or Gentile believer interested in Messianic ministry, please contact Jim by calling 540-525-4116. That's 540-525-4116, or email him at israelsfullness@verizon.net. Is Messianic ministry in your future? Call Jim Hendricks at 540-525-4116 or email israelsfullness@verizon.net.
Just Ask Joyce, where real life and family values connect. Hosted by author, speaker, and minister's wife, Joyce Oglesby. If you'd like to ask Joyce, call 571-2428. That's 571-CHAT. Ask a question, share a story, and preserve the faith.
Wanna leave a legacy?
Yesterday, before votes were tallied, I shot a video that some of you may have seen in which I said to the American people, regardless of which side you were on in the election, regardless of whether your candidate won or lost, the sun would come up in the morning.
And as I said in the 3 o'clock hour, it did. The sun came up. Now, many of us were very sleepy-eyed because we had been up until all matters of the night. I think, Webby and I went to bed after 3, I guess, and it was just, it was crazy. But we could not peel our eyes away from the television screen last night as the votes were being tallied all across the nation to determine the next president of these United States. And, of course, you know, if you are not aware by now, you should, I don't know, maybe you've been asleep all day. But Donald Trump is the victor. He is the new president-elect of the United States. He will take office January the 21st. I pray he is ready. By then, he's got a lot of preparation to do. And in some of it, quite honestly, is going to be hands-on training. I mean, he's going to learn by getting his hands wet because he has no experience in this, being a politician. I think he's a little bit more polished now than he was when he first began, but he's got his work cut out for him. But so do we, the people. But we, the people, spoke up yesterday loud and clear, and we sent a message to our political structure that, you know what, we're done. We're done. Now, I will say, and Garrett and I have already discussed it, Garrett Sivaking is in front of my face today again because he's no longer needed at the polls right now. I mean, I think you've got some cleanup work you're still doing, I know.
Yeah, well, and that'll be going on till the end of the year, more than likely. But yeah,
wow.
Getting registrations.
Really?
Well, you had so many new registrations mm-hmm. that came in that you have to go through and continue through that. And then a lot of people don't realize how extensive the infrastructure is. Those ballots have to be kept. They have to be stored and secured. The information has to be stored and secured.
For how long?
For 22 months.
Really?
22 months is how long everything has to be secured. All the paperwork, applications for absentee ballots, the returns of absentee ballots, military applications, how they came through, travel board applications. All those things have to be held for a long period of time. There's a lot of things that go on. And I think that's one thing that we need to remember. Our secretaries of state, our county clerks, those who, Bobby Holsclaw here in Jefferson County, Christy Ertin over in Floyd County, and several others across the Sherry Brown and Sally White in Harrison County, mm-hmm. those are, who are all friends of mine and across the spectrum, the work that goes into putting on the infrastructure of our democratic republic, our constitutional republic, is extensive. And we really should be thanking them and praying for them, time away from their families, time away as a service to us to simply walk in and cast a ballot.
Mm-hmm.
A lot goes into that.
A lot goes into it. But, we the people, you know, we have to come up. And I know we were talking before, Garrett, that, you know, Hillary actually got the popular vote. She mm-hmm. she won just by a narrow
right
margin.
That we know. I mean, there's going to be some things
that
change.
Still coming in?
Well, there could be. There's some situations there where you might have some ballots that are finally put through, whether they were military ballots or mm-hmm. who are provisional meaning that could not be certified at the polls, but were able to cast a ballot that was not counted. So within 10 days, we will know the final there. Either way, it was basically a 50-50 split when it comes to the popular vote.
It was really, really a narrow margin.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we wonder why, because we've been saying this, you've been hearing it, you know, this nation is really divided.
Yes.
And it has been greatly, greatly divided. And I believe that, you know, it's not happened quickly, Garrett. But it's brewed. I think it's really been turned up the last couple of years.
Well,
And
I think part of the problem was, and this is something I don't want to Monday morning quarterback anybody, but
right.
I tell you that the reason why we did the show the way we did it and the reason why we did the segments the way we did it was because in the end, we wanted the choice to be up to the mm-hmm. listeners and to the voters.
Mm-hmm.
And so many of our colleagues, so many of our outlets made calls way in advance saying that these polls were showing this and the trends were showing this. And I kept saying, now, remember, it's going to be a handful of people in a handful of states. And it really was, in the end, a handful of people
yes.
in some battleground states. Florida, and the edge went for Donald Trump. And that's why, and unfortunately, too many people have put their careers based upon what could happen. Mm-hmm. And I went back and forth, and I told you off the air, I really, at yesterday evening, well, Monday evening, going into the election, I thought to myself, it could still be anyone's game, but I thought Hillary had the edge.
Well,
I really did.
Obviously, I did too. Mm-hmm. That was my prediction from the beginning, and many of you have been waiting to hear what was in the envelope that I predicted in March. It was March 9th. Mm-hmm. And I remember that because that's my brother's birthday, one of my brother's birthdays. And so I remember that it was March the 9th that I made that prediction. But, you know, and my prediction was Hillary wins at all costs. That was my prediction. And last night, if I had made the prediction, it would have been the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
It would have been the same thing. And because I did not go into it thinking that we would have, you know, the outcome that we have today. I really didn't. Not that I didn't, as I said earlier, not that I didn't have the faith in the American people, but I saw what happened at the last election when so many people decided to stay home because they didn't feel like they had a candidate that they could choose from. And that was what we had this time, more so, you know, than ever before. And so the tenor, the very heart of us, of all the people, and many of the people, we were torn because, you know, when I made this prediction, Garrett, there were many candidates in that in that pool. I mean, we had a lot more to choose from. Some really savvy men,
mm-hmm.
Experienced politicians, very godly men.
And a strong businesswoman.
Strong businesswoman. I mean, Carly Fiorina, if we had wanted a woman president, let me tell you something. That lady was somebody to reckon with. She mm-hmm. was a power force. And until she held her own with all of those men, but was mm-hmm. never given the opportunity by the media. Mm-hmm. Never given the opportunity by the media to expose her abilities. Mm-hmm. And I will always believe that. But, but even then with the pool that we had to choose from, I'm like, she's going to take it. Mm-hmm. And I really, last night, I'm like, she's going to win. I think she's still going to pull this out.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, and of course, they kept us at bay for a long time.
Well, the voters did, too. I mean, the voters really just kept getting tighter and tighter mm-hmm. and tighter in places like Florida, even, you know, places that ended up going 6 points for like Georgia, but they were concerned. I mean, he was up by 16 points at one time, and right. then Atlanta came in, and that's what they were waiting on. And they thought they kept yeah. saying, I don't know how close it's going to be. But
Atlanta
really
could have been a toss-up.
Well, exactly. And Atlanta
Georgia
really, you know, put it through for Donald Trump in the sense that it just did not have the turnout that Hillary Clinton needed. Mm-hmm. Once again, urban areas did not have the turnout that Hillary Clinton needed to overcome other areas. And even some of the urban areas, Bucks County, Pennsylvania, which is a suburb of Philadelphia, that one was extremely close, within 5,000 votes. That's never close.
When did you decide, as a strategist and analyst, when did you decide what state was it that finally came in that you said, oh, okay.
North Carolina?
Was
that was the one that really got, when they couldn't call it, North Carolina, they kept going North Carolina. Another one that really, that I waited for was the fact that they could call Florida.
Mm-hmm.
Another one that really was another shock that I've said we need to spend time in. I said that over and over again about 2014 Senate. Hillary Clinton won the state of Virginia, but it was not by the margin that they expected.
No. And I felt like they should. But Wisconsin
really
was surprised.
And that was late in the night.
That
was the big one.
And and the surprise upset mm-hmm. for Hillary at that point.
Yes.
But guys, we're going to open the phone lines if you'd like to call in and talk about how you feel today after the election. You're glad it's over, or, you know, just shout out whatever you want to do or bemoan. 571-2428, 571-CHAT.
WFIA, The Spirit.
I couldn't get work opportunities without a high school diploma.
And I said, it's time for me to go back to school, get my GED, and further my education.
It was a feeling that I cannot explain. Once I received that GED, I decided to keep going to college and do something.
my son and I, we are stable. I pay the bills. I'm able to do all that because I got my GED.
Kentucky Adult Education, your future starts here. Contact your local Kentucky Adult Education Center today to begin building skills for credentials, college, and career. This ad sponsored by Kentucky Adult Education.
Offer not valid in all states or where prohibited by law. See website for details.
Need some extra cash today? Do you have bad credit or maxed out credit cards? If so, turn your radio up. 45cash.com is one of the nation's largest personal loan networks with over 50 different lenders. Now you can get a personal loan for up to $5,000 with any type of credit discreetly from your computer or smartphone and with no paperwork to send in. That's right, no paperwork whatsoever. Your cash will hit your bank account as soon as tomorrow, as our lenders have millions of dollars to lend, regardless of your credit history. Visit 45cash.com and you can have up to $5,000 in no time. Just have a checking account and a regular source of income, and you can get the loan you need now, regardless of your credit. Go to 45cash.com from your smartphone or computer to get the cash you need. Visit 45cash.com. Type www.45cash.com directly into the address bar. That's 45cash.com. 45cash.com.
Looking back on the Nye-Ham debate, this is Ken Ham, author and speaker on science and the Bible's authority. It's been a year since my well-known debate with Bill Nye, and we've seen a huge impact as a result. When I agreed to debate Bill Nye the Science Guy, my goal was to share the gospel, and I did, with a national audience of millions. Now, an interesting thing happened after the debate. Secularists actually used the debate for fundraising purposes, using Bill Nye's claim that he, quote, overwhelmed Ken Ham. But you know, to my knowledge, these secularists never made the debate available to their supporters. You'd think that they would want everyone to see how I was supposedly overwhelmed. Secularists know that science does not support evolution in millions of years, but they want people to believe it does. The Bible's history is true.
Want to know more about the age of the earth? Visit our faith-building website to learn how science confirms the Bible's history at answersingenesis.org.
When you listen every weekday to the Eric Metaxas Show, you'll hear from the people making news. Plus, we'll talk to some of the more surprising voices in contemporary Christian life. And did I mention fun? Yeah, I'm Eric Metaxas, and I'm trying to pioneer a new kind of talk radio. So join me every weekday for the Eric Metaxas Show. You'll never think about radio quite the same way again.
The Eric Metaxas Show, weekday afternoons at 2 on WFIA, The Spirit.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
Thank you so much for joining us today. We are wrapping a bow on Election Selection 2016, and we get to tuck it away for a while now, but never again 2016, as Garrett and I talked about. It's, you know, it may be, there'll be other elections, but, you know, this one's behind us. But Karen, thank you so much for calling in.
Oh, you're welcome. Can you hear me okay?
Well, yes. How are
I'm
you?
I'm good. I'm in the knob, so I may lose you. But one thing I did notice, I did stay up for the election, and I wanted to hear the speech. It was a long one. It was a nail-biter. My girlfriends and I, we were texting back and forth during prayers, during the, as we sat and waited for the numbers to come in. And but I noticed today, I thought when we finally found out that it was going to be Trump, I thought to myself, I'm not going to get on Facebook and gloat and rub it in
right.
because, they're my friends. And but today it has been the nastiest messages.
It's
horrible. They're just devastated. And just something, they're my Christian friends. And I look at them and I'm just surprised we're just all like on two different planets.
Wow.
I don't know. It's made me, it's just torn us. But I have not gotten on and put any messages on there. I thought, I'm not going to do that.
Take the high road. That's right.
I'm just going to lay low and let it. But it just breaks your heart.
It does.
How divided we are.
Well, we are, and of course, we had a caller yesterday, I believe it was, saying, we should not let this kind of rhetoric or this issue, of oppression, divide our friendships. And a lot of people have lost friends over this. Or family and family members. That's true. And
oh, it is.
And
yeah.
So,
but what do you do? I mean, I haven't responded. So thought I need to reach out to my minister and ask him, how do you open that conversation? Because it's a toughie.
And that, Karen, that's what I would tell you. I would not respond. I would not dignify it with a response. But you just pray for these people. And whenever you're around them again, if they say, "Why didn't you? Why didn't you think?" You just say, "Hey, guys, let's don't let this divide us. We have a relationship at stake. Are we going to let something like this divide us? I mean, we know that we've been separated on this issue, but we're still friends. We haven't changed. So let's, we need to unite and build this country and support, his efforts. I mean, my goodness, he's new at this, so we need to support his efforts, but let's not let it divide us. He's got to listen. He may disappoint all of us who voted for him. We don't know yet, but we've got to pray for him. We've got to pray for all of our leaders. We've got to pray for the Clinton campaign as well, and the people that are hurting from that. This is when we show Jesus to people. And, but you take that high road. You continue to do that. And, when you have that opportunity, you ask for God to give you those words, and he will. But tell them, let's not let this divide us in our friendships, guys. We've got too much history together.
Right. It's so easy to want to lash out and be ugly.
I know.
Thought, no, that's not my character. So
Nope.
I'm not even responding at all. I'm just letting it. I know they're just, they're just very devastated. They're
well,
so
they
sad.
Are. They are. But thank you so much for that call, and God bless you, and thank you for listening.
God bless you.
All right. And Tammy, thank you for calling in.
Hi there. This question, maybe Garrett can answer.
Okay.
And you. My husband, he doesn't vote, and I was wondering if there was, maybe some advice you could give me to encourage him, because his thing is, he says his vote doesn't matter because of the electoral vote. He said it doesn't matter. They're going to override it, so why should I bother?
Wow.
Well, this election's the perfect example. Mm-hmm. Hillary Clinton looks like she's going to barely edge out less than 100,000 or maybe between 100 and 200,000 votes in the popular vote. And then the Electoral College has gone pretty lopsidedly for Donald Trump in the sense of where those states, the big number states, went for him, Pennsylvania and Florida and Texas and those. But here's another one. Look at what I talked about the 3 o'clock hour about my friend Kelly Ayotte. Her Senate race is undecided at this point, 716 votes in over a million vote cast election. Do the math. It's very, very minuscule there. But by the way, the importance of the Electoral College was proven last night. The importance of the Electoral College is to let you know, if you look at that map, anybody who really questions the Electoral College, pick that map up. Look at the red, look at the blue, and look how close it was.
Mm-hmm. And I was so grateful last night as I was watching that unfold of the education that Garrett had given us about that Electoral College concept and why it was put in place and what the protection, why the protection is there for people. And, I was grateful for that lesson that he had taught us, because then I saw the value in it, because, I thought the same thing as your husband. So I'm like, what good is that? But I do understand. And of course now, I don't know whether it is just speculation from pundits or whether it's already in, they're already maybe putting it in motion. But I understand that they're trying to get rid of the Electoral College. And I don't know that that will happen. Do you, Garrett?
Well, that's a heavy load in the sense that you would have to amend the Constitution. It's constitutionally provided. You would mm-hmm. have to amend the Constitution, which would take 2/3 of the state legislatures on top of the Congress. It would take action across all 50 states. And once again, the victor of the Electoral College became president last night. And I don't think that anybody in their right mind would destroy something that got
And that
you
has
there.
Happened for the Democrats as well in the past.
Well, their argument's going to be that it happens for Republicans more often than it does. Because George W. Bush in 2000 was elected president without the popular vote. Mm-hmm. But you also have to remember that the popular... It's there for a reason to protect those populations. And the Electoral College has, it's gone both ways for people over the history of our country. And so I'm very proud that our founders, once again, their wisdom proves last night.
But hopefully that, you know, you can pass that on to your husband. Mm-hmm. But, you know, but every vote counts. I mean, and what yes. Garrett was saying about those yes. two, you know, those tight, this tight election, that one mm-hmm. that is just hanging in the balance now because, you know, of 716 votes, mm-hmm. you know, it's like, wow, if some people had gotten out and voted, that might not be.
And you today. Should. You should go look at those election results county mm-hmm. by county because there are some. You will always find county races where they're decided by less than 10 votes.
Wow.
Less than 10 votes. Though your vote does matter, and it really does make a difference up and down the ballot.
Yep. Thank yep. you, Tammy. God bless
Thank you.
You. Thank you for the call. All right, Garrett, you know, I made this prediction that, you know, Hillary would, and I was, you know, wrong on that. Mm-hmm. I made this prediction earlier in the show sometime this year. Where, you know, I said I believed that President Obama would be on a mission his last year in office just to undermine and override the authority of the Constitution or and really just bring damage, and I don't know how another word right now, harm, damage, whatever, to America. And so he's got 73 days left, and I'm just wondering what that's going to look like. Now, I say that because I woke up today, and here is an ACLJ memo that was sent out. Today begins President Obama's 73 most dangerous days. The election is over, but President Obama remains in office. He reportedly still has a huge agenda. Now, this is, you know, Jay Sekulow, and I like them. Mm-hmm. They're very credible people. He is plotting to abandon Israel, take numerous unconstitutional executive actions, and undermine the law. He will not back down from fighting the. We will not back down from fighting this insidious corruption. We have defeated his lawlessness before, including unanimously at the Supreme Court, but now in his final days, he is preparing to ramp up his lawless actions. We are prepared to defeat President Obama and stop him from crushing the Constitution. Of course, now my little letter has gotten overridden by something here, but they've filed 8 legal demands to stop. They filed 4 massive lawsuits in federal court confronting some of the issues. One is the Iranian law, the Iranian agreement, I guess, and his genocide action, and I can't read the rest. I don't know why something jumped up on top of it, but I will try. But that concerns me. I don't know about you. We'll be back after this short break.
WFIA, The Spirit.
When you think about being more like Jesus, do you ever think about the spiritual discipline of silence? When you ask yourself, what would Jesus do? Your answer might be pray. But is it ever pray and just listen? This is Chris Brown with the True Stewardship Minute. Mark 1:35 says, very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house, and went off to a solitary place where he prayed. Although Christ had a clear mission on earth, he made it a priority to withdraw and spend time alone with God. If we want to be more like Jesus in public, we should start by living like him in private. And if the Son of God needed quiet time with the Father, how much more do you think we need it? Set your alarm to go off 15 minutes early this week. Find a quiet place with no distractions and just be still and listen. Give God space to speak. He knows exactly what you need to hear. Find more ways to grow in your faith at stewardship.com.
All right, guys, Spalding University Center for Behavioral Health. You've been hearing me talk about them. They can help you with your family issues. Or if you're just struggling internally with something, maybe you have ADHD or you have a child who does, ADD, other issues, PTSD. We know that many of you veterans suffer with those kinds of symptoms. And maybe you've lost a loved one. Whatever it is that you are dealing with, let Spalding University and their team of professionals help you. Here's the beauty of it. It's low cost, it's high quality, and there's no waiting. All you have to do is call Spalding right now, 502-792-7011. That's 792-7011. Or you can go to behavioralhelp.spalding.edu and touch base with them there. The thing is, you can't get help until you begin. And why not begin with Spalding University?
It started at Bunco Night. A little tickle my throat, says Sandra. Then comes Colin barking like a seal. That cough, that's the flu. And then it spreads to Edna, to Wiley, to Marjorie. But when it comes to your door, you won't be answering because you got your flu shot at Rite Aid, where they care about you and your health. So while they're seeing doctors and sweating through fevers, you'll be teaching your granddaughter the two-deck shuffle. Shield yourself at Rite Aid before it's too late. If you're over 65, the CDC recommends flu and pneumonia shots. No appointments necessary, and they're free with Medicare Part B. Rite Aid. With us, it's personal. Flu vaccines available while supplies last. Age restrictions apply in some states. See pharmacy for details.
I'm Nick Soboleski, a SelectQuote agent with a true story that could save you hundreds of dollars a year. A woman named Linda just called. Her husband, Ray, has a $300,000 group life insurance policy, but is changing jobs and can't take it with him. Well, I impartially shopped the highly rated term life insurance companies we represent and found Ray, who is 41 and takes medication to control his cholesterol, a 10-year, $500,000 policy for under $26 a month. That's almost twice the coverage for less than half of what he had paid. If SelectQuote hasn't shopped for your life insurance, you're probably paying too much.
For your free quote, call 1-800-566-2424. That's 1-800-566-2424. 1-800-566-2424. Or go to SelectQuote.com. We shop, you save. Get full details on the example policy at selectquote.com/commercials. Your price can vary depending on your health, issuing company, and other factors. Not available in all states.
By now, everyone knows Class Act Credit Union offers some of the very best rates on auto loans. But the savings go way beyond low interest rates. Many lenders charge application fees, credit fees, and prepayment penalties. But not at Class Act. And you'll save even more on related products like GAP and extended warranty policies. Best of all, you'll get personal service from friendly, knowledgeable people. Ready for a new car? Apply online at classact.org today. Class Act Federal Credit Union. It's like straight A's for your money.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
No dream is too big. No challenge is too great. Nothing we want for our future is beyond our reach. America will no longer settle for anything less than the best. We must reclaim our country's destiny and dream big and bold and daring. We have to do that. We're going to dream of things for our country and beautiful things and successful things once again. That was the thing.
And Spalding University. No. Oh, we are back. Is that what we are? Gary and I was talking. I'm sorry. I'll just be honest. I'm like, Gary's pointing at me, and I'm like, why are you pointing at me, Gary? Because I've already done Spalding University. Of course, I'm just going to tell you again while I have you on. Spalding University can help you overcome many of your problems, and I would encourage you to give them a call. So, sorry. That's nothing like real, Gary. That's why people love me, because I'm just real, and I own what I do. There you go. But we have Garrett Sivaking here today, and we've been talking about, of course, election 2016, and it's over, guys. That part is over. Not for us. I mean, for us, but not for you, Garrett.
No.
I'm sorry. You still have a lot of work ahead of you. But when we went to a break, I was talking about this letter from the ACLJ, and of course, now that my pop-ups went away, Jay Sekulow went on to say that we have filed 8 legal demands to stop the out-of-control corruption. We have filed 4 massive lawsuits in federal court confronting the Iran lie, number one. Number two, the pay-to-play collusion. Number three, the genocide inaction. And number four, the DOJ corruption. He says, we're beating back the IRS. Now we're ready to go back to federal court. And, of course, they urge you to help them in their support. They do a great job. They are our monitors, you know, for justice. And I love the ACLJ, and they do fight hard for us and our rights. And but, you know, I'm hoping that I am wrong on that prediction, too, that he just doesn't do anything that is just out there that I got really mad about the website, the giving over, you know, the internet. That one I felt like was huge. And I don't know if I can get more angrier about, you know, what he did, because that was just, I felt like that was just huge. It took it out of America's control. So I don't feel comfortable with that anymore at all.
Well, you know, you've got a lot of things that can happen in a lame duck. You know, you have executive orders, you have legislation. What's interesting is you won't have a changing of power in the Congress, so it doesn't really, you won't have that. That's when it's really dangerous, by the way, is if you have a big sweep, like in 2010, when Republicans took the House, when there was a big difference between those 73 days of Congress into that first one, that was dangerous. You had a lot of things that could get sent down the pike through that, because you had members of Congress had nothing to lose. They'd already lost their seat.
Right.
You don't have that this time. And I also think that I will hope that President Obama keeps the tone he did this morning. His speech this morning was extremely well written. It was extremely well delivered, just as the speech from Hillary Clinton was
well delivered. It was very passionate. It was excellent.
Yeah, and I feel for her and her supporters today. But I think that now is the time, and I've said this all along, we have to come together now. We have to unite. The country is divided. We have issues that we agree on. We need to make sure that those issues that we agree upon are dealt with, because we cannot have eight more years of nothing.
Right.
I mean, we just have really had nothing happen since the Affordable Care Act. That was really the last piece of monumental legislation that was passed through the Congress. And since then, that has been riddled with problems, and no one's been able to fix them, because no one will come together to work on changing that system once it was passed. So the time is now. You know, we have veterans who are in crisis. We have families who are in crisis. Our education system is in crisis. We have a budget deficit problem. We have a national debt problem. We have a problem in our military, where our military has become lame in many situations and in many aspects around the world. And then we have allies around the world who are in danger. One of them you talked about was Israel, but we also have allies in Europe who are in danger from an encroaching regime in Russia and Putin. We have migration that has caused the uptick in terrorism around the Western world. So we have to be strong and continue to work together. Americans have survived elections for centuries. We can do it again.
571-2428, 571-CHAT. If you'd like to call in and comment about the election, we welcome your call. We'll be back after this short break. Don't go away.
WFIA, The Spirit.
Hi, this is Chip Ingram.
Hi, I'm Chuck Swindoll.
This is Steve Arterburn. Congratulations, Louisville. For 50 years, you've been blessed with a radio station in your community that has helped spread the good news of the gospel and help bring new followers to Jesus Christ.
We're so proud to be a part of such a historic milestone.
From all of us, a very sincere happy anniversary.
Thanks for listening to Louisville's Christian Talk and Teaching Station. Now 50 years on the air. We're WFIA, The Spirit.
Not all financial advice is crystal clear, and even the pros often disagree about what course of action is best in different circumstances. That's why the best financial advice is traced back to the fundamentals, the basics, uncomplicated nuggets of wisdom that seem intuitively true. For example, Mom always used to say, money doesn't grow on trees, and she was right. Of course, Mom wasn't being literal. Like so many other pieces of advice from Mom, this was more symbolic. She was saying that money doesn't come easily, so you must protect it, keep it safe, and don't waste it on frivolous things. Hi, my name is Kevin Roberts from Roberts CPA Group, and today I want to help you protect your money so you can find the financial freedom you've been working so hard for. That's why I put together a free resource that lays out some of the most valuable pearls of wisdom from someone we all looked up to. I call it Lessons from Mom, motherly advice on health, wealth, and the pursuit of happiness. And I want to offer this special resource to you absolutely free. To claim this free resource and start putting your money to work for you and gain the financial freedom you're after, simply request it online at robertsfreereport.com. Again, visit robertsfreereport.com.
Welcome to Staples.
Staples guy, I have to move fast in business. Gotta go, go, go.
Well, then you need to see the all-new redesigned HP OfficeJet Pro printers.
Are they fast?
They're lightning fast and deliver two-sided prints, which saves you time and money. You can even print from your smartphone.
Sounds perfect.
And now at Staples, you can save up to $100 on one.
Fast, efficient, and I save money? So I can relax.
I can see the tension melting.
Yep, gotta go.
Away.
Now save up to $100 on a fast new HP OfficeJet Pro. And save every day on ink and toner. Staples. Make more happen.
For limited time, see store staples.com for details. Restrictions may apply.
Just as God is using WFIA in your life, God is using TWR through Bonaire. This is a good ministry that WFIA is 100% behind, a ministry you can trust. We encourage you to get behind this incredible project, this opportunity to reach Cuba with the gospel of Jesus. Imagine Christian radio coming to Havana. You can make that happen. Call now, 888-256-1600, or go online to WFIAFM.com and give generously. We are excited to partner with TWR in this effort. By joining hands with an international radio organization like TWR, WFIA is helping bring great Christian radio to Havana and the rest of Cuba. You're a big part of that. Your gift will make it possible. Will you call right now? You can reach TWR operators at 888-256-1600 or at the WFIA website at WFIAFM.com.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
We will also finally take care of our great veterans. We've been so loyal, and I've gotten to know so many over this 18-month journey. The time I've spent with them during this campaign has been among my greatest honors. Our veterans are incredible people. We will embark upon a project of national growth and renewal. I will harness the creative talents of our people, and we will call upon the best and brightest to leverage their tremendous talent for the benefit of all. It's going to happen. We have a great economic plan. We will double our growth and have the strongest economy anywhere in the world. At the same time, we will get along with all other nations willing to get along with us. They will be.
He's got some big plans, some big dreams. And, of course, you know, we talked about the dreams the last segment, and I was snoozing. I was dreaming, I guess. Garrett and I were dreaming. But Veterans Day, I like his plan for the veterans, and I pray that our veterans are taken care of, as does Garrett. Tomorrow we will have a veterans show, by the way, so make sure you join us for that. But, Carla, thank you for calling in.
You're welcome.
How are you feeling today about this election?
Oh, you know me. I'm ecstatic.
Well,
and I had called in, remember, on your
yes,
show?
Yes, yes.
And you remember what I said?
No. I mean, I think you were hoping that Trump would win.
Yeah, I said that I believe that American people will pull through.
Yep.
And that I think that the media was just making it sound like Hillary was the one, and they were trying to sway it. And I said that I just prayed that America would make the right choice and that Donald Trump would have a sweep. That's what I predicted. And I'm like, I was just praying. And I just feel like God answered my prayers.
Well, you know, the American people got out and voted and
right.
did their thing, and you know, mm-hmm. our voice was heard. So
yes.
Again, as Garrett has pointed out, you know, she received the popular vote. She received more, and I think what you said about 100,000.
Yeah,
so
it's up right now, and mm-hmm. it can go back and forth, but it's going to be
votes
it's
are still
be
coming
half
in.
And half, really.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's going
it really
to be a pretty good split right down the middle. So that tells mm-hmm. me, that we've got a whole lot of work to do as a people. Mm-hmm. In this nation, Carla, where we come together as a body of people that respect, lives, that respect authority, that respect, and value each other as human beings, that we, cross those, racial divides and the religious divides and all, we come together as God's people, still keeping God in authority. We cannot take God off the throne. If we take God off the throne, then we're in trouble.
Right.
But, you know, we have to come together as a people. But the party lines, I think, is just there's such a demarcation there. And I believe that, you know, if we don't make this effort, take this opportunity to do that, then we're going to continue to be a divided nation. And I would hate to see that.
Oh, I know. I'm just so happy because you were just talking about veterans, and both of my boys, as you know, are in the Air Force.
Yes.
And I am, quite frankly, I was scared to have her as their commander in chief. And I know it was somebody said that about her, I mean about him, but I'm telling you, I feel like he really is looking out for the military by what he has said, and with the veterans, and you know, that's the backbone of mm-hmm. our country. You know, we've got to build up our military, and you know, and just stand for that and go back to being patriotic. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, I'd like to see some good old hard patriotism come back to America, across, you know, sweep across this land. But again, you know, right now it's words. Donald Trump has got to come through on these promises. I think every campaign is full of promises, Garrett. I think you'd mm-hmm. agree with that.
Mm-hmm.
But and some have been lived up to, and some have not.
Yes,
I know.
But he's got a lot of work ahead of him. But you know, we all do, and he can only do so much. But we the people must do it out here, amongst ourselves, you know, and just embrace each other with love and forgiveness, and you know, and just get along. That's what I would love to see us do.
Well, and a strong leader brings people together, and he has an opportunity now to bring a lot of people together mm-hmm. through Congress, and he has a lot of issues that maybe he didn't take a strong stand on. Now he can listen to the American people and leaders on both sides of the issue and come together to provide leadership there. That's part of what leadership is all about. Mm-hmm. And it all depends on who he surrounds himself with his cabinet. That's going to be some interesting 73 days.
That's what I was about to say. If he just surrounds himself with some good people and knows, you know, the best route for America. And I think he has a level head, and I'm just so thankful it was him and not her.
Well, thank you so much for that, Carla. God bless you. And thanks for listening. You call again sometime. You know, Garrett, the next 73 days, I was going to ask you about that. What, you know, his presidency kind of really begins already today in a sense, not in official capacity, mm-hmm. but he's got a lot of work to do. So
the transition team begins. And then, mm-hmm. of course, tomorrow is a very pivotal moment. And I think that we should all be praying for Mr. Trump and President Obama as they meet for the first time to begin the transition process and know how that's going to go. As President Obama said in his speech today, he was extremely thankful for how President Bush handled his transition in 2008. I hope that he will take that model from President Bush and do the same with his transition now. That's going to begin a process of not only the cabinet members that we think about, but the ones that we don't. Ambassador to the United Nations, one we don't think about a lot. That's one that's going to be very pivotal and how that's handled. Secretary of State, of course, mm-hmm. Which I hope goes to former UN Ambassador John Bolton, who was under George W. Bush. Carla was just talking about the military. Secretary of Defense, I'm really hoping that goes to Jeff Sessions of Alabama. And also, you have to remember, as the members of Congress who are being sent in to be part of the cabinet, then we will have openings there. So you'll mm-hmm. have some special elections in certain states, depending where it's called, and some appointments from governors. Another thing, quick side note, you know, Homeland Security, of course, immigration was a big deal. Arizona finally has been pulled over into the Trump column, 49.6 to 45.3, with 100% coming in. That was kind of a shock because John McCain's race was called pretty early, and he did handily beat Congresswoman Ann Kirkpatrick, 53.3 to 41.2. But the biggest,
well, Arizona was where the Clintons are from. So,
well, Arkansas.
Yeah. Arkansas. That's right.
But you know,
Arizona is where all these immigrants are pouring into.
Yeah, right. The border security issue. But of course, the big blow to a lot of the Trump team was, of course, the defeat of Maricopa County Sheriff Jaro Opayo in his reelection. It was handily defeated by the Democrat. Of course, he's under investigation at this point. And that probably had a lot.
Probably had a lot to do with it. Well, you know, I think that certainly some of the issues that surrounded Hillary right there at the end probably might have had something to do, not with her supporters so much, but with maybe others coming out.
Right.
All right. We'll be back. We're going to wrap up this election selection 2016 today.
WFIA, the spirit.
Could your skin use a little lift without surgery? That invasive process? Well, why not try About Face Spa and Salon? If you have a problem area, Tia can specify the protocol to target those trouble areas, whether it's laugh lines, rosacea, acne, sagging neck and jowls, eye lifting techniques, whatever you need, she can do. Call her and get an appointment today, 812-288-2300. Tell her Just Ask Joy sent you and get a discount.
Licensed in all states. Product availability varies. Agents may be compensated on enrollment.
Michael Stahl is my guest. He's the vice president of Health Markets. Health Markets is trying to make this crazy Medicare system easier to understand. Would you explain how it works?
So Health Markets offers a free service with access to thousands of Medicare plans nationwide to help folks maximize their benefits and save their money. Enrollment in the right plan is not automatic. With so many Medicare options out there, it can be confusing. So my advice is to don't go it alone. Get unbiased help to help find a plan. It may cost less. It may cover more with lower co-payments, more choices like dental and vision care, and the freedom to see the doctors you choose. Best of all, Medicare assistance is free. Our licensed agents can do the work for you, making the process really easy. The Medicare enrollment deadline is only weeks away, so it's important to act now.
Call Health Markets today.
For your free Medicare assistance, call 800-246-3290. That's 800-246-3290. 800-246-3290.
This is Hugh Hewitt for the townhall.com Weekend Journal. In a fast-paced world, you want more than just facts. You want insight on the news that's shaping the world around you. Get it from Bill Bennett, Mike Gallagher, Dennis Prager, Michael Medved, and me. I'm your host each week on the townhall.com Weekend Journal. Give us an hour. We'll give you all the week's events from a perspective you can trust.
Stay informed with Town Hall Weekend Journal. Saturday evenings at 8 and Sunday afternoons at 4 on AM 900 WFIA. The Spirit. You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA. The Spirit.
Thank you so much. Friends, thank you so very much for being here, and I love you all too. Last night I congratulated Donald Trump and offered to work with him on behalf of our country. I hope that he will be a successful president for all Americans. This is not the outcome we wanted or we worked so hard for, and I'm sorry that we did not win this election for the values we share and the vision we hold for our country. But I feel pride and gratitude for this wonderful campaign that we built together, this vast, diverse, creative, unruly, energized campaign. You represent the best of America, and being your candidate has been one of the greatest honors of my life. I know how disappointed you feel because I feel it too. And so do tens of millions of Americans who invested their hopes and dreams in this effort. This is painful, and it will be for a long time. But I want you to remember this. Our campaign was never about one person or even one election. It was about the country we love and about building an America that's hopeful, inclusive, and big-hearted.
All right. There you have it. Secretary Clinton's concession speech this morning, and you know, encouraging. She really had a wonderful message, encouraged people to unite and support the president. We all, she says, we all need to do that, you know, and work with him. And so we're hoping again, Garrett, that unity will be the message, the life lesson that we all learned from this election. It was one of the dirtiest, I think, that's ever, maybe we've ever seen, at least in a long time. One of the hardest fought. And, you know, and it cost a lot to the families. The families were the one I felt like really took a lot of punches in this election with the mudslinging. And I always have a heart for that. But, all right, Gary, this is it. With this election, Selection 2016, of course, we know that, you know, there'll be other things, but you're going to carry on with your show.
Of course, One Nation on Sundays at 9
Plug
p.m.
It. Yep.
And, you know, we'll continue to have that. And, of course, Joyce will have me on to give updates about Congress and different things as we go through. One of the things that we have going forward is the Senate, you know, not still really decided how much of a divide we have. Kelly Ayotte will go into a runoff. We'll go into a recount. The Louisiana race is going to go into a runoff. So we're going to have that coming up to see who fills that seat. As I said, there'll be seats that will probably be opened by cabinet appointments. And of course, the other one is on Fox News last night, Joe Manchin, the West Virginia senator, said that he was not going to promise that he would remain a Democrat through a Trump presidency.
Right. And we got a call, Garrett.
Okay.
Janice, thank you so much for calling in.
Hey, thank you. God bless you guys and God bless America.
Amen.
Amen. I just kind of wanted to be able to say that how grateful and thankful I am to God for the USA and for you guys there too, and for all the information that you shed it on us, and I'm just so appreciative, and I just thank God for his move and for the people of God that stepped up to do their due diligence. I'm so overwhelmed and proud, and I don't know why. It seems like I went to work today, and of course, they've kind of held it all over the place where you couldn't even put your signs out. And as bad as I wanted to put my yard signs out for Trump and everything, I feel convicted a little bit because I didn't. I should have, but I was a little bit of, I'm just being honest, I was kind of fearful because when I went to the office to pick them up, and they were like, well, they were asking me if I was certain because there could be some repercussions. And I kind of prayed about it. But nevertheless, I was wondering, would it be, because I don't want to be globed for anything, but I'm happy. You know, we have a right to be happy.
Mm-hmm. Janice, we got to go. We'll let Garrett answer that real quickly.
Yeah, if you put the sign out. Let it
put
be
the
out
sign
there.
Out. Be proud. Be proud, girl. Thank you so much, guys. We'll be back tomorrow, same time, same place. Thank you, Garrett. Love
you're
you so
welcome.
Much.
Thanks, everyone.
In the meantime, we're in battle for his cause.
The Spirit, 94.7 WFIA FM, New Albany, Louisville, is a service of Salem Media Group, online at WFIAFM.com. Focus on the Family is sponsored by Focus on the Family on WFIA The Spirit.
I don't have a mom or a dad. My friends do.
Hi, this is Jim Daly from Focus on the Family, and I was one of those kids. God tells us to take care of widows and orphans, and that's why at Focus on the Family, we've launched the Wait No More events.
Join us for the Wait No More event Saturday, November 12th at Little Flock Baptist Church in Shepherdsville. To register for this free event and for more information, visit iCareAboutOrphans.org. That's iCareAboutOrphans.org.
Well, what I have seen is that the Christian conversation can sometimes sound just like a big thou shalt not. And we treat sex, when we talk to our children, we treat sex, it's almost as if we would say, we're putting you on a diet. But we don't tell them that there are benefits.
Well, that's an insight from Dana Gresh, and she's our guest once again on Focus on the Family with your host, Focus President, and author Jim Daly. Thanks for joining us. I'm John Fuller.
John, last time we had a great discussion with Dana Gresh about sexuality in general and what the body chemistry is, God's design for intimacy, the way that we bond with oxytocin and dopamine and other things, and just how that area of the brain for men and women are different. Women have that larger area of the brain that creates that bonding, and men have about half the size of that capacity for that bonding. And yet it shows such a beautiful picture of how God really intended it. Dana also mentioned research that showed that men who were older at the end of their lives said what they felt about their sexual experiences. Those that had few or maybe only one life partner in their wife had the greatest satisfaction and the greatest connection with their wife. And those that had multiple partners had less satisfaction, less happiness in those experiences. I think that that says it all. And that is probably for me a great point for me to talk to my boys about tonight when I get home and begin.